Good morning. This is All India Radio, Kohima. The morning news read by Jonas Yantan. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will visit Assam and West Bengal today. Prime Minister will dedicate to the nation important projects of the oil and gas sector at Silapathar in Temaji, Assam at around 11:30 a.m. In West Bengal, Prime Minister will inaugurate several railway projects in Hooghly this afternoon. Comptroller and Auditor General CAG of India said that under the national pension system, the Nagaland government has failed to transfer 62.01 crore rupees to the National Securities Depository Limited, NSDL. The CAG report for the year ended 31st March 2019, tabled in the Assembly by the Chief Minister Nipirio on Friday last, stated that the government collected 86.74 crore rupees from the employees as contribution towards NPS and contributed only 58.17 crore rupees as government's share towards the scheme. The report pointed out that the government did not discharge its statutory liability as it failed to contribute 28.57 crore rupees as government's matching share under the NPS. Further, it reported that against the total collected funds of 144.91 crore rupees, the government transferred only 111.47 crore rupees to the designated authority, NSDL, and did not transfer 33.44 crore rupees to NSDL for further investment as per the provisions of the scheme. The report therefore stated that there was a short transfer of 62.01 crore rupees to the NSDL and the current liability stands deferred to future years. The CHA report further stated that the state government has created interest liability on the amount not transferred to NSDL, incorrectly used the funds that belongs to its employees and created uncertainty in respect of benefits due to employees, adding to financial liability of the government in future, leading to possible failure of the scheme itself. A total of 390 projects involving expenditure of 1,252.87 crore rupees from various departments in the state were incomplete as on 31st March 2019. The CHA report stated that out of these, two projects involving an expenditure of 10.47 crore rupees, which were taken up by the BWD roads and bridges, had been suspended. It said information regarding target year of completion in respect of 67 out of 390 projects were not furnished by the department, though called for. The possibilities of the incomplete projects being abandoned cannot be ruled out, as many of the projects are over 5 years beyond scheduled completion date, the CAG report stated. It further said the project cost in respect of 14 incomplete projects was revised from 200.90 crore rupees to 339.46 crore. Increase of cost related to projects on the BWD roads and bridges was 60.50 crore rupees, geology and mining 27.41 crore, State Council of Education, Research and Training 0.69 crore, Transport 5.09 crore, Veterinary and Animal Husbandry was 0.14 crore, Youth Resources and Sports 12.02 crore rupees, Agriculture 0.01 crore, Social Welfare 7.08 crore and Forest 24.72 crore. The CAG pointed out that the funds borrowed for implying these projects during the respective years proved ineffectual, with the state having to bear additional burden for debt servicing and interest liabilities. The CAG therefore suggested that the effective steps need to be taken to complete all the projects without further delay. Since the introduction of Nagaland Liquor Total Prohibition Act 1989, the revenue earning of the Excise and Prohibition Department has been reduced drastically. As per the administrative report of the Excise and Prohibition Department 2020-21, tabled in the recent Assembly session, the revenue receipts on excise duty and license fee from April 2020 to January 2021 was 165.15 lakh rupees, while the revenue receipts of the department in 1987 to 1988 was 584.37 lakh rupees and 2016 to 2017 was 461.09 lakh rupees. In addition, the department has detected and registered a total of 1,187 for narcotics and liquor cases, and 1,188 persons were arrested. Over 1,10,85,000 people have been administered COVID-19 vaccine in the country so far. The Health Ministry said India continues reaching new milestones in terms of administering COVID vaccine doses to record number of beneficiaries. Meanwhile, the COVID-19 recovery rate in the country has improved to 97.25%. And as the nation fights COVID-19 pandemic, let us all remember to stay safe and protected by following these three simple steps. Wear a face mask, wash hands frequently with soap and water, or use hand sanitizer, and follow social distancing norms. With that, we come to the end of the morning news. Have a nice day.